Devotees of the Black Nazarene who will join the upcoming procession in Manila urged to mask up amid the rising cases of COVID and flu-like illnesses. Robert Mananao joins us with that story. Robert, over to you.
Armina, leaders of Quiapo Church and the local government of Manila are urging devotees in Quiapo and those attending the Carino Grandstand activities in relation to Nazareno 2024 to wear face masks. Manila Mayor Hany Lacuna mentioned that during the January 9 masses, face masks will be distributed on Villalobos Street before entering the church. They will also enforce physical distancing inside the church. The Manila LGU expects around 2 million devotees per hour. On January 9, there will be a liquor, firecracker, and gun ban around Quiapo area. The Black Nazarene now has a new courage surrounded by tempered laminated glass. The church reminds that climbing onto the courage is prohibited. Only wiping with a handkerchief is allowed. For the January 6 pahalik, devotees are requested to refrain from kissing the cross and feet of the Nazarene. It is advised to simply wipe with a handkerchief. Medical personnel and field hospitals will be deployed for the safety and well-being of the devotees. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Robert Mano, there joining us on the line. And Philippine energy regulators urging the National Grid Corporation to be in close coordination with power plants on Panay Island. That's as the island continues to experience a widespread blackout after its power plants failed Tuesday. The ERC says communication between the NGCP and the power plants is key to prevent such outages in the area from happening again.
One of the key recommendations and very low-hanging fruit, as if I may put it that way, recommendations last time by the interim GMC, is improve coordination and communication protocol between the plants and NGCP. And in the checklist of in the report that was submitted to us by NGCP, in the checklist, they ticked it as completed. So if there are, if the protocols are in place, the recommendation on the proper improved communication measures are in place, how could this have happened still? So those are the questions we need answers to when we conduct this investigation. The grid also has to evolve. And what we're feeling right now, I think, we're in an evolution phase of the system. We need to all, you know, get our act together to make sure that all parts of the system can work. If we really want, you know, if we really want our system to become more resilient.
Meanwhile, the NGCP said the situation is out of its control. It, however, assured residents on the island it is doing its part to solve the problem.
Ng kuryente at ang NGCP ho, kung wala hong supply na maihahatid, hindi ho namin masolusyonan yan kasi nakasalalay din ho kami sa mga power plants para dun sa supply na i-deliver. Sumulat na ho kami kay Mayor Trenas at nagbigay na ho kami ng mga suggested solutions.
Despite that assurance, Philippine lawmaker Franz Castro believes NGCP should be held accountable for the blackout in the area as well as in some parts of Negros. A teachers group warns congestion in public high schools in the Philippines will worsen following the discontinuation of senior high school programs in state universities and colleges. Joyce Balancho reports.
Single mother Julian Beldad is worried for her child, who is an incoming grade 11 student next school year. Having no job, she has no choice but to send her child to a public school. But she has fewer options after the Commission on Higher Education, or CHED, released a memorandum on December reminding state universities and colleges, or SUCs, and local universities and colleges, or LUCs, to discontinue its senior high school programs.
Mahirap sa kalagayan ko, kasi sa kalagayan ko wala ako trabaho. Eh, kung magpa-private po mo yan, hindi rin ko ma-sure na makakapagbayad kami sa tuition ng bata.
CHED says these should only be offered during the transition period of the K-12 curriculum or from school years 2016 to 2017 and 2020 to 2021.
DepEd signed an agreement that during the transition period, state universities and colleges can offer senior high to use the excess capacity of classrooms and teachers. And these students will be paid by DepEd through vouchers. The transition period is already finished. It stopped. It finished in 2021. The public universities now have full capacity because their enrollment has increased. And therefore, there is no more legal basis for them to be offering senior high.
Through the voucher program, DepEd provides financial assistance to SUCs and LUCs to cover for the expenses of grade 11 and grade 12 students who they accepted. For this school year 2023-2024, DepEd has allowed grade 12 students who are currently enrolled in SUCs and LUCs to finish their studies. Those who wish to take education programs in laboratory schools will still be allowed, but with certain limitations.
Sa mga may laboratory schools authorized by CHED, except there is a cap that they must have no more than 750 students for their whole high school. That should be commensurate to the enrollment that they have. Kung masyadong malaki ito, konti lang estudyante nila, that's not their mandate. They're only using it so that their students can practice in these schools.
There are 114 SUCs and 146 LUCs in the Philippines. CHED says most of them offered senior high school programs in 2016. Majority of them have stopped the program since 2021. This development is a concern for the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, or ACT, which argued that public high schools may not be able to handle all incoming senior high school students in the succeeding years, given the limited facilities and teaching personnel.
Tingin namin ay darating tayo sa mga punto na magkakaroon ng tinatawag na Saturday classes, pwedeng umabot na third shift, o kaya talaga pinakamiserable rito ay magkakaroon ng tinatawag na doble at siksikang mga estudyante sa loob ng mga classroom. At yan yung isang pangamba namin na lalo magde-deteriorate yung kalagayan ng edukasyon natin.
DepEd says there are 17,700 grade 11 students currently enrolled in SUCs and LUCs who might be displaced following the discontinuation of the voucher program in higher education institutions. But the DepEd assures students there is enough room in public high schools to accommodate them.
It will not affect their education. Of course, they will have to transfer. No, that's one thing from their SUCs and LUCs to the public schools. But it will not affect their education naman po. And we want to make sure nga na ma-accommodate natin lahat ng maaring ma-displace.
Another option for senior high school students, DepEd says, is to avail the voucher program with the private schools, which has not been stopped. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
After a month-long suspension, the Philippine Social Welfare Department resumes its program that helps poor Filipinos pay for medical and funeral expenses. Jervis Manahan with the details.
The Department of Social Welfare and Development has resumed the issuance of guarantee letters for Filipinos in need of cash aid for medical and funeral expenses. This service was suspended last month.
This is to confirm doon sa mga requirements ng ating financial management service na kung saan kinakailangan nating i-collate, no, lahat ng mga kinakailangan nating bayaran. Dahil, of course, we have to pay for the services of our service providers, particularly yung mga hospitals and mga funeral parlors.
Guarantee letters are given to qualified applicants requesting medical and funeral aid above 10,000 pesos. However, the release of outright cash assistance has been temporarily suspended as the agency awaits funds.
Ito ay sa kadahilanang naghihintay rin naman ng DSWD ng pag-download ng pondo. So kinakailangan na may notice of cash allocation mula sa DBM bago tayo makapagbigay din ng cash doon sa ating mga kababayang nangangailangan.
The Department of Budget and Management, for its part, says it has released the first quarter notice of cash allocation for DSWD and is only waiting for the crediting of funds in Land Bank. The public has been advised to monitor the DSWD social media channels for the resumption of this service. The DSWD, however, continues to receive applicants for cash aid.
Naghanap kami ng kung saan pwedeng humingi ng tulong, so yun, salamat sa Lord. Merong DSWD. First time ko kasing nag-seek ng help dito. pero sa tingin ko malaki yung tulong na nabigay nila sa akin.
Kami nang para sa pang-discharge niya kasi malaki yung bills na na-cover ng ginamit sa ospital.
Okay.
So, ito yung lang yung option namin para makabawas. Ay, sa amin naman pabaraman kasi yun ang kailangan namin sa bills.
Okay.
Guarantee letter.
To qualify for aid, applicants must submit documents such as hospital bills, promissory notes, government IDs, and social case study reports from the social worker handling the case. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.